In this world of technology, IoT is a trending field and it is growing day by day. Since physical objects and the digital world is now connected, so by keeping this in mind, Espressive Systems released quite adorable and bite-sized Wi-Fi enabled microcontroller named as ESP8266 in a very cheap price. It is a perfect choice for any IoT project and it can monitor and control things from anywhere in this world. In this video, I am going to introduce you with the NodeMCU board and we will study the basic components of this board in detail. We will also have a look at its both versions and see the main differences between them. We will also learn how to program it with Arduino IDE and in the end, we will blink the onboard LED of NodeMCU board. So let's begin. Before moving ahead, take a moment and press the subscribe button and enjoy various other tutorials that are specifically designed for both beginners and advanced level users. You can also press the notification bell if you don't want to miss the new upcoming videos of NodeMCU series. Hi everyone and welcome to Engineering Online. Let's have a look at the brief introduction of NodeMCU development board. NodeMCU is a development board and it uses the most popular ESP8266 Wi-Fi chip. The reason it became most popular because it is a Wi-Fi ready microcontroller by itself and there is no need to use Arduino board with it. So let's have a look at the main components of this board. First we have ESP-12 module. NodeMCU features ESP-12 module which contains ESP8266 chip and it operates at 80 to 160 MHz clock frequency. It has 128 KB internal RAM and 4 MB external flash for program and data storage. It also comes along with 802.11 Wi-Fi transceiver. The transceiver does not only develop connection with the Wi-Fi network and interact with the network, but it can also set up its own network and allow other devices to connect with it. This feature of the ESP8266 has made it more versatile. Now let's have a look at the power requirements of this board. The operating voltage range of ESP8266 is within the range of 3 to 3.6 volts. The board contains LDO voltage regulator to provide steady 3.3 volts and 600 milliampere current. The output of the regulator can be taken from various pins labeled as 3V 3. These pins can be used to supply power to external components. This NodeMCU board is powered via an onboard micro-B USB connector. If you don't want to connect USB cable, then you can power it from 5V voltage source via V-input pin. This board has total 17 GPIO pins. These pins have been assigned different peripherals duties which includes a 10-bit ADC channel, 2 UART interfaces to load code serially, 4 PWM pins for controlling motors and dimming LEDs, an SPI and I2C interface for all sorts of sensors, and I2S interface to add sound. So all these GPIO pins are multiplex, so a single GPIO pin can perform multiple functions. There are two buttons on NodeMCU board. First one is reset button to reset the ESP8266 chip. The other one is flash button and is used as a download button while upgrading the firmware. It has an onboard LED indicator which is user programmable and it is connected to the D0 pin of the board. It contains CP2102 USB to UART bridge controller which converts USB signal to serial, so that computer can be used to program and communicate with ESP8266 chip. There are two main versions of NodeMCU boards till now, that is version 0.9 and version 1.0. The main difference between the two versions is the design of these boards and ESP modules. In first version, CH341SER USB to serial converter is used, whereas in second version, CP2102 USB to serial converter is used. First version uses ESP-12 module and second version uses ESP-12E module, that is enhanced version. There are some extra 6 pins, that is MTDO, MTDI, SD3, MTMS, MTCK and SD2 added onto the ESP-12E version. Although NodeMCU is Lua based firmware of ESP8266, generally, Explorer IDE is referred for writing Lua scripts for NodeMCU. It requires to get familiar with Explorer IDE and Lua scripting language. So there is another way of developing NodeMCU with a well-known IDE, that is Arduino IDE. We can also develop NodeMCU applications using Arduino development environment. This makes things easy for the Arduino developers than learning a new language and IDE for NodeMCU. So let's see how to set up Arduino IDE with NodeMCU. First of all, make sure that you have downloaded the latest version of Arduino IDE. Link to download Arduino IDE is added in the description box. Next, connect the NodeMCU module with your PC through USB cable. So first of all, make sure that USB driver is installed. Open Device Manager and update your drivers either manually or automatically from internet. Now open Arduino IDE, go to the File, then Preferences. On the Preferences window, enter the following link in the additional board manager URL. I have added this link in the description also. Now close Preferences window and go to the Tools, then Board, and then Boards Manager. In Boards Manager window, type ESP in the search box. ESP-8266 is shown here. Select the latest version of board and click on the Install button. After the installation is completed, open Tools, then Board, and then select NodeMCU 0.9 ESP-12 module, because I am using 0.9 version. Let's blink the onboard LED of NodeMCU to verify that it is working properly. Open the blink sketch from the examples. Make sure that the correct COM port is selected here. Compile it and then upload on the board. And here it is, the onboard LED is blinking. So that was an introduction of the NodeMCU board and how to program it with Arduino IDE. In the next video, we will discover more about this development board and develop advanced projects with it. Now try it on your own and provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. I hope that you must have learned from this video. You can do many more exciting projects with NodeMCU board. That was all for today. Do like the video and share it with your friends and fellows. Subscribe to our channel for more interesting and informative videos. Plus, you can also connect with us on Facebook and Instagram. Links are added in the description box. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you next time with another amazing tutorial.